What's going on, guys? It's the Beastly Gamer here. Let me turn off The Legend of Zelda real quick. I wanted to talk to you guys about something that's pretty, some people would call incredible, some people would say horrifying, and some people would say incredibly frightening. Information has come to my attention over the last 12 hours, 24 hours, I would say. Today is March 18th. Nice, beautiful Saturday here in Georgia. Yesterday wasn't quite as bright due to some crazy information that came to me in my new home. Now, a lot of you guys, especially the new subscribers, who thank you all so much for supporting my channel. Don't know, I recently acquired my first home. I bought a house here in Jonesboro, Georgia. And I'm the kind of person that's had kind of a crazy background and history with things that people would consider supernatural phenomena. As a child, I grew up in a haunted house. And so my first impulse when I talked to the realtor who was showing me this property was to ask her, has anything strange ever happened in this house? Has anyone been murdered in this house? Anyone done anything crazy? Anything in particular? And she looked at me. She said, no, nothing. Nothing like that at all. And I was like, okay. Then she said, well, the first thing you do in any house anyway is you lay down salt and you say prayers and you build spiritual barriers. And she started going through all this stuff. And I was looking at her like, well, if nothing's ever happened in this house, why are you giving me this information, huh? Anyway. Yesterday was Friday, and I got called out of work early by my son. He was sick in high school. He called me from the clinic, and the young lady who's working in the clinic said, your son's having issues. He's having trouble breathing. His heart's hurting. I don't know how you can tell that, son. But I ended up leaving work early to go pick him up. And on the way home, you know, I got a call from work. They asked me if I was coming back, and it was just too far away, so I ended up staying up. I got home to my new home, and I decided to cut my grass for the very first time. You know, grass isn't growing super fast this time of year, but I got a new lawnmower and I wanted to try it out and I wanted to make my yard look nice. So I decided to start cutting some grass, not smoking grass. And I'm just starting out. I've just turned the lawnmower on, and my neighbor, a guy who I don't know, I only know one neighbor so far, a young lady next door named Vicky, older lady. But this super old guy, frail old white man, came over to my house while I was cutting the grass. He was standing behind my van in the driveway. And by the time I noticed him, I was like, oh crap, let me turn this lawnmower off and see what this guy wants. And so I turned off the lawnmower and I started approaching him, and he had some mail in his hand. He checked his mailbox. He said something that was really off-putting and weird. He said, you been here long? And I was like, hmm? He said, have you been here long? I said, about a month and a half. And then he asked me another question. He said, are you related to the man who used to live here, the previous owner? And I said, no, why, yeah. He said, well, you look like him. I said, no, I don't know him. He said, yeah, well, he killed himself in your backyard. He hung himself from that tree by your shed. Yeah. So I looked at him. I was like, he hung himself. He was like, yeah, he was a sheriff deputy for Clayton County. He was a child molester. And he was molesting some girl in your house, and she ran out the window, and he killed himself on his court date. So I was like, you know, holy shit, that's what I'm thinking. And for the people who don't know if this is true or not, I will provide links and the video and all the information. You guys can pretty much find out where I live and come here and torment me and my family. Don't do that. But anyway, this guy continued to tell me the story. And so I had my front door open. I'm cutting the grass. I told my wife, I had the door open, the screen was closed. I called my wife and said, babe, come out here and meet our neighbor. And so she came to the door and she was looking out and she stepped outside. I said, this is Paul. Older guy named Paul, 65 years old, had open heart surgery 2 weeks ago. He's walking around. You know, he's telling me about all the pain inside and how his innards feel from having open heart surgery. And he started to tell Kate about himself. He told Kate that he's getting married, you know, to the lady who's living with him, and how it's important for him before he's going to sleep in a bed with a woman, whether he does something or not, whether he needs to be married. And I was, you know, I appreciated the conversation, but he wasn't telling Kate what he told me. And so after about 5 minutes of him going through this, you know, explanation of who he was and his history and how he's been living out here for 40 years, I said, Paul, do you mind telling my wife the first thing you told me? He said, oh, yeah, I told your husband he looks like the guy who used to live here who hung himself from that tree in your backyard. I see you guys cut down some trees. And then Kate looked at me like, mm-mm. And I looked at Kate like, holy shit. So check this out, okay? When I was meeting my realtor for the first time and at this property, She, you know, went through the whole house with me and basically went through the explanation of the direction that the previous owners were going through with the house and how a lot of it, the things that are here now didn't used to be here. For instance, my studio used to be a garage. Now it's like one of the coolest rooms in the house. You know, 4K TVs everywhere, plush, thick carpet. You know, when you step around this room, you leave a footprint. The carpet's so nice. And I really like it. I came in here and painted it up. And she was telling me, you know, some of the other things in the house, the way that they did the air and the heating together. And it's really cool. But when we went outside, because I have a huge backyard, which I want to show you guys. Actually, I'll show you guys now while I'm talking to you. This is my backyard. And so that's my patio set. That's my tetherball set. I love tetherball. But when we were walking out here initially, my realtor, she told me there were some trees back here that needed to be cut down. One in particular behind my shed there that's no longer here. But, sorry guys, I love tetherball. I can't walk past this thing without hitting the ball. I used to play this in middle school, and it was like the greatest game ever. So, you know, when I buy my first house, I got to live the dream and have tetherball. But this is my storage shed, and this is a huge yard, as you guys can see. And there used to be one of these gigantic trees back here, like trees as thick as that one there. There's you can see the stump of another tree they cut down. But when we first came out here, the day before I moved out here, she was telling me about these trees. She said that there was a tree back here in particular, this tree here, that needed to be cut down because she felt like it was leaning toward the front of my house, like leaning over the storage shed. She felt like it was dangerous. I have kids. And so they wanted to cut that out, cut these trees down. She said one at first, but when they came, they cut this one too. Sorry, I have a dog next door, and he went to the vet. But, so when I moved in, she sent this team of hardworking Latinos out here, and they fucking cut those trees down. And she asked me about it, and you can see there's still plenty of pine everywhere. And there was nothing to be said about it, you know. And of course, when I asked her about the house initially, she told me nothing toward it ever happened here. And it was one of those situations. So when this guy is telling me this story yesterday, talking to me and my wife, it all started to make sense. And so I came inside the house, and I was like, you know, I asked the guy, did he know the man's name? He said, no, he was a Clayton County sheriff, black guy. He said the girl was 13 years old. He said, if you go on Google, you'll be able to find it and everything. And so, of course, I was able to find this information and validate my address and all this crap. So I know that this guy actually did this here. And here's a link to the actual video. Here's the video I'm going to share with you guys right now.
New at 6, a teenager says she had to jump from her bedroom window to get away from a deputy who allegedly sexually assaulted her. Channel 2's Tom Jones is live in Clayton County, where he learned the girl is related to the deputy's girlfriend. Tom.
Yeah, Javita, according to this warrant, Deputy Philip Richards was supposed to be babysitting
the 13-year-old. Fucker.
Told police that she was so afraid that she kicked out the screen to a bedroom window, jumped out, and ran to safety.
42-year-old Philip Richards had to be shown which way to go as he went before Magistrate Court Judge Richard Brown. One might think he would know his way around the courtroom since he's a Clayton County deputy, a deputy who now faces serious charges that will keep him behind bars for a while.
Under Georgia law, cannot set a bond at this time for aggravated child molestation. That has to be on a separate bond calendar.
Richards faces aggravated child molestation and another sex-related charge.
The other charge is sodomy.
Committed a sexual act on a female juvenile who was sleeping on the floor.
According to this warrant, Richards was babysitting the teenager. The victim says she fell asleep in her mother's room watching a movie. She says she woke up to find Richards attacking her. The child says she then ran to her room and locked the door.
She climbed outside of a window and left the incident location.
She then ran to a relative's home. Richard said next to nothing in court.
Do you have any questions?
No, sir.
And the Clayton County Sheriff's Office told me that Richards has been placed on administrative leave without pay. He will remain behind bars, a place he works, at least until a bond hearing is scheduled for next month. We're live in Clayton County. Tom Jones, Channel 2 Action News.
Yeah, so that actually happened, guys. And what can you say about that? You know, it's sometimes the truth is stranger than fiction, and my life has always been really weird like that. But this bastard, and I'm thinking it happened in my room. You know, he assaulted this little girl. She's sleeping in her mother's room, so I'm guessing that's the master bedroom. He went there and tried to rape and sodomize this kid. She ran into another room. I don't know which room. And the fucked up part is, I have little girls here. You know, my daughters are 6 and 4 and a newborn. And I don't know if any of this happened, you know, where they sleep at night. But anyway, this guy took it upon himself to, let me just share the article of what happened. Because he went to jail initially, and after he was jailed, he got out, made bond or bail or whatever he needed to make, and he decided to not go to court. Apparently, he said court was out. Here's the article. I'll make sure there's a link in the description. Ex-deputy found dead on day molestation trial was to begin. A former Clayton County deputy accused of child molestation was found dead of an apparent suicide Monday morning after he failed to show up for his trial, according to police. Philip Emmanuel Richards, then 42, was arrested in March for allegedly assaulting a 13-year-old girl, the Atlanta Journal-Constitution previously reported. The girl told police she awoke to find Richards attacking her, so she ran, climbing out of a window, and running for help. Richards' trial was set to begin Monday morning, according to Clayton County Superior Court docket. He was charged with aggravated child molestation, aggravated sodomy, and sexual battery, court records show. He was out of jail on bond. Police were called Monday morning to Richards' home, where he was found dead. Jonesboro Police Chief Franklin Allen told the Atlanta Journal-Constitution, Richards' death is an active investigation, Allen said, but every indication is that Richards committed suicide. So, yeah, this is real life right now. This is my house. This is a purchase, like a lifestyle purchase. And I called my mom yesterday and told her this. I called my dad. I called my dad's wife, my stepmom, who actually is a friend of the realtor. And nobody knew this. Now, I called the realtor yesterday. As soon as I came in the house, I sat down for a minute, you know, wiped the disbelief out of my eyes, talked to my wife about it, and I called the realtor. And I said, so, we just found out that a Clayton County police officer, sheriff, committed suicide in our backyard, and he molested and tried to rape and sodomize a little girl in our house. She said, what do you mean? I said, there's a guy who hung himself from that tree in the backyard that you wanted to cut down. She said, no, you're joking. I said, I'm not joking at all. And I started reading her the same article I read to you guys, and she was like, no, she couldn't believe it. Well, that's the way she sounded. Even though, I mean, she seemed pretty adamant about cutting that tree down, she sounded so believable on the phone. She sounded sincere. So, I mean, maybe in her mind that tree was dangerous. I don't know. Maybe because, you know, the original owners, this guy owned the house, and then the house was bought at a very cheap price from the person who sold me the house. So I don't know if they knew, but it's just one of those crazy situations. I mean, sometimes you just can't believe that these kind of things can happen. My kids aren't worried about it. A lot of people say, oh man, thank God that tree's gone, because that negative spirit would inhabit that tree and, you know, there'd be a dead guy hanging there at nighttime looking at your house. Let me just tell you like this. I grew up in a house with lots of crazy things that have happened to me. If you guys want to find out, just look back at some of my real true stories in Minecraft series. So I know that these kind of things exist, but I've also learned as I've gotten older that positivity supersedes negativity. And like, if you live in a house that has a lot of drama and a husband and wife who hate each other, and one's cheating and the other one's snorting a line of coke, I mean, and then you got kids that are disrespectful and saying, fuck you, mom, I hate you. Then situations like that, you got alcoholic parents, situations like that can actually really infest your home. But we found nothing but happiness and joy here. And like I told my mom last night on the phone, you know, it's like a hard drive. A house is like a hard drive. You can put all kinds of bad stuff on a hard drive. There could be child porn all over a hard drive. Does it make the hard drive bad? For the moment, but you can partition and delete that hard drive completely and put 900 episodes of Barney on it and make it a different thing. And so our life is good. I wanted to share that with you guys because it was very, very strange to me. I found this out yesterday, and it was just one of those wacky situations that you would never believe. And this guy's name is Philip Emmanuel Richards. This happened in Jonesboro, Georgia. And I'm sure if you guys dig deep, you can find out pretty much the area I live in. But I wanted to show you guys this and share this story. I really would like to hear you guys' thoughts on this. As far as the direction we should go in the future, as far as living here. Should I start like looking, you know, up in ceiling panels and trying to find hidden compartments? Because if this guy was doing stuff like this, more than likely he was corrupt in some other ways. There might be like a bag of $50,000 he stole from a drug dealer someplace and four illegal guns. There's like a big crawl space under my house that I've got people coming to waterproof this week because there's a weird smell, but it smells like stale water, I guess. I don't know. It's like I want to tear this house apart now and see exactly what this guy was all up to, but part of me wants to just leave it alone and make video game videos and talk to you guys in my vlog. You guys let me know what you think in the comments below. Hope you guys are having a great weekend. This is a strange situation. Philip Emmanuel Richards, rest in peace. And the young lady, if you ever see this video, I hope you found peace in your life. And I am so sorry this happened to you. I got daughters that live in this house. And I don't know if I'll ever explain to them, you know, exactly what happened here. But it's just one of those crazy situations. Who knows? You might live in a house that has a torrid history and you might not know it. But thanks to Paul across the street, 65 years old, open heart surgery for spilling the beans. My mom said, "Ooh, that your neighbor's a bastard. He just had to tell you that, didn't he?" I said, "Mom, I'd rather know than not know. Are you insane? Wouldn't you rather know if Jason happened in your house?" You guys have a great week. Hope you guys like the video. Give a thumbs up. Show support for my channel. Join the Facebook group. Follow me on Twitter. And you guys can share your own videos and thoughts at BeastlyGamer.com. I'm the Beastly Gamer. And I'll see you guys next time.